Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are back to Let's Play Blue Dragon on hard mode on the Xbox 360. Last time, we beat the Guardian Kirin, or Blazing Kirin, or whatever that damn thing was. Yeah, the Blazing Kirin, and got the power to open blue barriers. So now we can go ahead and get all the blueberries in the game, I think. I think we can get all of them. If not all of them, at least most of them. Like, maybe, we might be missing like one, but for the most part, we can get most of them. And yeah, so now there's going to be some extra robots, I guess. I forget. But these guys are pretty funny to watch. This guy right here. You tell him about the robot being opened or whatever. It seems a barrier has come down. I'm glad that there are more places to clean. Seriously, dude. You're a complete workaholic. So this guy still doesn't like us. Oh well. And here's the slacker. You've been taking a short break since I got here, but guy. But anyways, let's see. Let's grab the blue barriers in town first, because there's I think four of them. Let's see. I don't think there's one in the inn. I think there's one in here though. Where are all these barriers? No, this isn't. Wait, is this a waiting room? No. It's in a place called the waiting room. I remember that much. Might be in here, actually. Yeah, there's. No, I think there's like three, not four. Alright, waiting room. Here we go. And let's open this bad boy up. Yeah, see? It just disappears. No gotta equip anything or nothing. And what do we get for our troubles? We get
item.
Very magic heart. Okay, that's nice. That would have been useful a few hours ago when I was grinding, but eh. It wasn't too bad getting up to 42, and then I just popped the seven barrier hearts that I had. I didn't use all of them. I was like, oh, I'll save one. Let's see, I think there's this one right here. Sorry about that, I was trying to mute that, but I guess I messed up. Flawless Sapphire. I don't know why some of these are protected by barriers. I mean, the Flawless Sapphire isn't really that great. And there should be one more. I think it's in this house right here. There we go, generalist. Very nice. Again, those aren't going to be too useful anymore until we get to the later levels for grinding up for the achievements, but yeah, they're there. Alright, before we go off after all the other blue barriers back in the previous towns, let's go advance the storyline just a little bit. Yep, all the blue barriers are going to be gone now. I don't think you have to research any of these. Or maybe you do. Never mind. Okay, I guess you do. Let's give that to Zilla. Okay, I didn't think you had to research all these, but apparently you do. Oh well. Aha, so we can go back outside. Alright, this guy right here. Wait, you're not the guy I'm thinking about. Well, you can buy Grand Light Crystals, so that's pretty nice. I think most of these new robots don't stick around for long. Let me check. Actually, these guys might stick around for a while. I don't remember. And I don't think I have the negotiation skill equipped. But we'll come back and get some of these later. So I think this guy does stick around, actually. But there's another guy who doesn't stick around. Where is he? Let me make sure I check this one, and then if I... Okay, I checked that one, so that means I'll start over here next time. Is it you? No? Probably this guy right here. Yeah, this guy right here. Make sure to buy at least one each of these Super Metal bracelets and Super Metal rings, because I don't think you can get them anywhere else in the game. And this guy will leave pretty soon. I think it's sometime near when the next plot advancement is. Let's see. Yeah, let's grab two bracelets and two rings. And you know what? Before we do that, let's put on our negotiate skill. Let's see, who wants to negotiate? Maru? No. Zola? Yeah, probably Zola. Absorb HP and negotiate. There we go. Yeah, so this guy, like I said, he's not going to stick around for very long. He's going to leave eventually. Did I already buy those? Okay, I did buy them. Okay, good. I wasn't sure if I did. Let me just make sure. Alright, there we go. You know what? This might poison somebody, but you know what? I think that's a decent enough attack boost to miss out on the poison and the slight MP boost. Yeah, that'll work. And then let's give the other one to... Yeah, let's give that to you. And then for the Super Metal Rings... Well, you don't even need it, do you? Nope, I guess they don't really need it. Oh well. But the point is, we got it. It's in our books now. That's nice. No, I don't have any status helmet secure. There should be one more robot around here. Where are you, bud? Where is he? Ah, this guy right here. There we go. Yeah, finding out some new spells. Quicka. So that increases it by 29%, I think. So that's much better than Quick, which increases it by 9% your speed. Attack Up. Very nice. That'll be useful. And Walla, which basically is Wall, except for a magical attack. And there we go. Nice little increase in our repertoire of skills. And that's pretty much all the good stuff around here. I guess I could buy a few of these guys right here. Let's see, I have four each, and let's see, how much would it cost to buy 16 each? 6,000? Yeah, that's probably a lot. You know what, let's just grab a... Let's grab a few of each, I guess. Yeah, these are kind of expensive, but oh well. Anyways, let's get the rest of this stuff. I'm not going to bother going through that door yet, because that's the next storyline area, and I want to go do some other stuff first. Max MP, let's give that to Shu. Why not? Can I get back to the other rows of the other guys? I don't think I can. I just realized the guys that were selling stuff, I think they came out of the pods. I never actually paid attention to that.
Nothing.
Ooh, SP plus 2. It's kind of weird that I'm doing Shu's assassin training instead of Zola's, but... Oh well, it's not going to make too much of a difference. And I think we searched all those already. I don't think there's anything else in here that we can do, is there? Yeah, I think that's pretty much it here. So, let's go ahead and go grab some of those blue chests. Let's start at the one in Jabral Castle. Because we can check in on the Nothing Man while we're there, see if anything's going on. See if we got enough nothings for anything new. Probably not, but oh well. Hey, we don't need to go to the cafe. I don't think there's anything new going on in there. We might be able to get to some optional boss side quests today. I remember them being reasonably easy in the normal mode, but this is hard mode. Yeah, they weren't super easy, but they were... I didn't die on them, let's put it that way. So I'm not sure how strong they're gonna be now. Alright, last time I was slightly short. Aw, I'm still short. Oh well. Anyways, let's just go get that blue barrier out in the courtyard. Or the, not the courtyard, the... Yeah, I guess it's kind of a courtyard. It's the welcoming yard area, place, thing. That guy's got some spiky hair. Are you guys gonna rent the place out yet or what? Anytime soon? No? No? Is this guy back in here or no? He is... not. Where did he go anyways? Yeah, oh well. By the way, the laser field, it still attacks you when you go out there. The robot chief or whatever, he didn't turn it off or anything. It kind of sounded like it might have, but he didn't. I don't think he has any control over it, actually. I think it attacks you for the rest of the game, now that I think about it. Alright, blue chest. There we go. And a poo bracelet. That right there instantly kills any poo type enemy in the game. Any one hit, and they're dead. Then again, poos are reasonably weak, so it's not that great. It can be useful for two super bosses, which are of the poo variety, because it'll kill them in one hit too. But if you want a challenge, just keep it unequipped. I'm gonna try to do them without the poo bracelet because, well, that would just make it too easy. Okay, let's go somewhere else now. Let's see, we already got Jabral Castle. Let's go to... let's see. You know what? I just realized we gotta go to the Jabral, the basement in the castle. I forgot about that place. I forgot that was a blue chest. I thought it was a red or a white chest. Oh well. Luckily, it's actually closer to the warp point than the other one is. So it shouldn't take us too long to get there. Let's see, off to the basement. Hey, what happened to the big Gorgo guy that was guarding this place? Oh wait, he's downstairs, isn't he? Yeah, there he is. Yeah, those red and white chests, not yet. Eventually, just, well, not today. Okay, red chest in here. I think the blue chest is in the laboratory area. Maybe that's why I thought there was only red and white chests down here, because I saw these and I forgot about the other ones. There it is. And a shell earring, which automatically casts the shell status on you. I forget if the shell and the shield earring go up as your spell goes up. I don't know if they always cast the middle spell or if they cast the third spell when you get that one. I'm not really sure, actually. But anyways, I think that's all in here. Let's see, we got the Jabral Castle basement, Jabral Castle town gate. Let's go to Alamaro Village real fast. Because we can go there was a chest behind Jilala's house, I believe. So I wonder if Jilala and Guru, or not Jilala, Guru and Sura are going to rebuild the house, or if they're just going to move into Jilala's house. That's what I would do. Jilala's got a nice mansion. It's certainly a lot better than the rest of the huts that everybody lives in. And I guess that one dancer chick is still dancing. I thought she only danced for the duration of the time you were in the basement of Jilala's house, but I guess she just stays dancing indefinitely now. Ooh, Alacrity Elixir. I think that erases your speed? I forget. I don't have all the elixirs in this game memorized. Yeah, speed, okay. Let's see, we can give that to Maru, you're kind of slow, aren't you there, bud? Wow, I didn't realize Maru was so slow. Oh well. He'll live. Anyways, our next destination shall be... Let's see, we gotta go to the Undersea Cavern. Where was the Undersea Cavern? I'm trying to remember where that was by. That was by, Force of the Dead. Force Camp. Nope. Where was the Undersea Cavern by? Well, when I remember where that is, we'll go there. But for the time being, let's head out to... the wilderness camp right here. Where the heck is the Undersea Cavern? I forgot where the heck that place is. You know what? Let me look that up real fast, because, well, I forgot. Oh, it's over by Marmaro's house. Okay, never mind. I wasn't sure if it was by there or by Talta Village. Item. Ooh, Ancient Warrior's Bracelet. That should actually be pretty nice, actually. Let's give that to Shu. Yeah, Poo Bracelet. Instantly kills most types of poos. There is one poo that it does not kill, but it kills everything else. Yeah, look at that. 120 attack and 10 agility. And it might petrify him. That's pretty nice. Let's see. Should I give that to you? Let's see. You have 95. Yeah, let's give that to you, because Zola definitely has a higher attack right now. So there we go. That's nice. Alright, let's see. Let's go to... Let me see. We gotta go to the Lot Wilderness, I think, east? And I think this will take us there. If not this, then the other one will. No, we need to go east, not west. Okay, so I think we're in the wrong one here. It's nice that they let you warp from anywhere and not just certain areas. Oh, I never, we haven't showed off our new field barrier skill yet, have we? Well, now's our time, I guess. And there's our chest. Yeah, look at that. It's all sparkly. What's that? You want to die? And only cost 1 MP? Oh, look. There's my MP for killing you back. Already. Nice. You know what? These little rat bastards deserve to die. And you little scorpion shits, too. But yeah, now that it only costs the one MP to kill him, it's basically free, because, well, you'll make that SP back within a matter of seconds after, as long as you have the regenerate MP on. And even if you don't, it would still take killing 10 enemies just to go through 10 MP, so... That's basically, let's see, magical medicine restores for 20 MP, so that's 20 enemies for 1 MP, or 1 MP potion, basically. Cross trainers, those I think those just increase your speed. Yeah, it just increases your agility. You know what, let's give those to Maro, you're kind of slow right now, actually. But then again, everything you have is actually good for you. So he'll live. He'll be slow, but he'll be powerful. Anyways. Let's see, where else can we go? We can go to the... Let's see. Let's go to the drill machine. Let's see, the barrier should be around here somewhere. I think it's on the first or second floor. I don't think it's on the third floor, though. No, this isn't where I'm trying to go. Is it? No, this takes us outside, right? Yeah. Actually, you know what? This will actually take us, This will take us outside, and that means we can just, go to the first floor. There we go. Actually, now that I think about it, the next barrier opener isn't too far away. Alright, second floor. That'd be you right here. And Asian Warriors necklace, very nice. Let's see, who wants that? Let's give that to... Do you want that? Well, you don't need the Ordeal necklace anymore, because you got the ballet shoes. Ooh, nice defense. Yeah, you'll get that. There we go. Now Maro is even more of a champ. And let's go warp out to the Ancient Hospital. We gotta go there. Let's see, where is the... Again, I think it's on the second floor again. Everything seems to be on the second floor in these areas. That's not where we gotta go. We gotta go the other way. I thought the warp point was by the save point in this dungeon. No? Oh well. Where the hell am I? Wait, do I have to go the other way? You don't come to these areas for so long, you forget where to go everywhere. Let's see, we gotta go... Yeah, I guess we do gotta go across this big empty room. Oh well. I like the music in this area. It's very nice. It's got kind of like a weird techno-ish beat to it. Kind of. Hello, Wolfie. Die? Yes, die. Alright, where's the stairs to go down? We need to go downstairs. Where are the... Yeah, they're around here somewhere. I don't think that's it. Let's see. Why are you trying to attack me when you know you're gonna die miserably? Let's see, I think this takes us... Oh yeah, there we go. Alright, Blue Barrier, you are... Where are you? You're over there. Okay. Can I even reach over there? I think I can. Good night. Ah, there we go. Fine, don't search the bed then. Ooh, 3 SPS, nice. We go around the little pile of rubble. Ancient Warrior's Earring. They're giving us all sorts of Ancient Warrior stuff. See, that'll increase magic defense, I think. So again, I think that'll be something Maromaro might appreciate again. Alright, so that's done here. Let's give Maromaro some more defense then. Actually, no, you got the shield earring, don't you? Yeah, I think the shield earring will be fine for right now. So let's give the... See, that prevents poison. Yeah, sure, why not? You could use a little more defense. Alright, and now let's head over to Largo Village, and then the Undersea Cavern, which I forgot it was by there, but oh well. And then we got one more area after that, but that's not going to be for a few minutes at least. Okay, I don't need a close-up of Klook there. Thanks, though, but... Are you guys still thinking about those magic words? Yeah, okay. See, I don't think there's any barriers in here, at least not that I know of. Yeah, so let's just get out of here and find the barrier in the Undersea Cavern. And then the last one is over by Palta Village, I do believe. See, is this the way to... Which way is this taking us? This is going to take us to... Is this going to take us to the cavern, or is it going to take us to the other field area? Yeah, I think it does take us to the cavern over here, yeah. Okay. I wish you could, like, kind of tilt the camera up a little bit instead of having it at a fixed height. That would make it easier to see where you are. Because as it is right now, I'm not sure exactly where the cave entrance is. I know it's around here somewhere, but we just gotta find the little bastard. Oh, there it is. No? No, this is a treasure chest. You never got this? Huh. Yeah, copper necklace. That could have been useful a while ago, but oh well. Alright, where the heck is this damn cave entrance? Where are you, you little bastard? Ah, there it is. And I think the chest is kind of near the end of the area, right? I think so, actually. Oh well, at least we get a couple SP points out of it. Why not? Regenerate HP. Yeah, that's not really anywhere near as useful as regenerate MP, because, well, you can use the MP to heal your HP, so it's just not all that useful, I guess. Plus, you typically have less MP to restore than you do MP, so the... Did I just walk around in a circle? I think I did. Yeah. So the MP is just going to be more effective. Ah, I see where I turned. Okay. Supposed to go up, not down. Yeah, you little jellyfish bastards. Ah, there it is. Check that I actually didn't want to open it there. Ooh, flip-flops. It has water-resistant powers. Sure, why not? Yeah, there's not really too many great accessories right now, but there'll be some much better ones later on. And I think that's all of them in here. Let me make sure I got them from all the other areas. We got the... Wilderness East, Wilderness Sheep Center, Camp, whatever, the Drill Machine, Asian Hospital, Undersea Cavern, Jiral Castle, both of them, Elamaro Village, and the Robot Towns. Alright, I'm actually going to go ahead and go over to, Tulta Village, and I'm going to go ahead and make my way to the Ancient Caverns, you know, where we had, like, our first battles of the game against the first Poo Snakes or whatever. And then next episode, we're going to go ahead and get the chest down there and see if we can't try some of those optional bosses. So I will see you guys then. So guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good night.